Welcome back, guys. Today we're going to build ourselves a Raspberry Pi with Grafana, Influxdb, Node-RED and MQTT. A Raspberry Pi that you can use for graphing your inverters and solar systems and even battery systems if you like that, and you can use it for many other things. Let's get going. Before we start, you need a couple of things to do this build, and first of all you need a Raspberry Pi. This image here that I'm going to use is based on the Raspbian, the Debian version, and I have built it for Raspbian, a Raspberry number 2 and the version 3, even though I recommend version 3. You also need a small micro SD card, and the minimum size is 8 GB, but I do recommend 16 GB or larger. You will need some kind of SD card reader or writer to be able to actually write down the data to the SD card. And when you get this up, I do recommend some kind of screen solution for your Raspberry so you can get the network running. If you do not have a screen or a monitor that you can hook it up to, you can also get the IP address of the Raspberry via your DHCP server. And last but not least, you need a big mallet or hammer. We start with load our SD card into our reader, like that. And as you can see, my reader came up. So let's go to my DIY Tech and Repairs webpage, where we will find the manual that I have created. And we then go down a little bit and we will find links to the installation page for the Raspberry Pi. And you have it here. And you will need to install a program called Etcher, that is for writing the SD card. And you find that here. When that's done, you will get this image up. It's now time to go back and download the ISO, and you press the download ISO here. You will get one file, and you will get the zip file here, the Raspberry 5 in this case, depending on the version of course. It should be around 2 GB. When that's done, you take your program, the Etcher, you select the image. You go to the folder where you stored them, you select the file that you downloaded, and you make sure that the device itself is the one that are the SD card, and you press flash. This will take a couple of minutes depending on what sort of card you have, what sort of write you have and everything, and how fast that goes. While we are waiting for the download to commence, it's actually a good part to read through what's going on here. This page will be describing a little bit about the software installed on it and also on how you should set it up. First of all, the software that is installed on this ISO. First of all, we have the Grafana. Grafana is for actually visualizing the data itself. We have Influxdb. This is a time series database. We have the Graphite API. That also is a time series database. MySQL, in this case, is just a normal database that you can use for whatever you want. And then we have the Mosquito MQTT, that are the MQTT broker. And on top of that, I have installed Node-RED, that is a good tool to actually take data from different sources and manipulate them and send them to another source. Of course, we have Apache installed with PHP and everything, so you can have your web page running if you want that. For administration, we have VNC server. That is a visual tool that you can connect to the machine itself, the graphical visual tool like TeamViewer or Remote Desktop. We also have Webmin, that is an HTTP-based administrator tool that you can administrate the Raspberry Pi itself. As I said earlier, you need the Raspberry Pi version 2 or 3. I do recommend number 3, it's a little bit better, and you have the wireless built in directly. 8 GB of SD card is the minimum. I do recommend 16 GB though, or even bigger than that. To get the network address, as I said, you need some kind of screen or mouse, or you need a network tool that you actually can find it. There is also links on the Raspberry Pi webpage where you find the installation of the system itself on how you do that. So I recommend, for that kind of questions, you should go to raspberrypi.org. When we have it flashed, we will go back, take our SD card out and insert it into our Raspberry Pi, and we flip it up. I'm going to use this screen here, as you can see. It's a really nifty little setup, 7-inch touchscreen. So let's boot this up. And we can see that it boots. When you boot this up the first time with the screen, you will get a warning message, the same message as you get when you SSH to the machine. And that's why, because the SSH is enabled and I have not changed the default password for a Raspberry Pi user. You can ignore that for now, but if you're going to make this safe and you're going to have it on the internet, you should change this. I'm pressing OK. So basically, this is the view you have. You first of all need to make sure that you have internet access. So I'm going to press on the wireless. And in my case, I have the Esprit running. If you wouldn't have had that running, you have been pressing on it and you would have connected to it. By connecting to it, you will get the IP and everything that you need. When that's done, you need to figure out what IP you are running. If you do not know that already, start up the command prompt. And in the command prompt, you will get a lot of data here. So what you need to do now is that you need to run sudo ifconfig. By doing that, you will get all this bunch of data up. And as you can see here, you have the VLAN 0, the information here. And what you need to look for is this part. It says 192.168.8.141. That's the IP address. If you're hooked up to the network card instead, the wire, you need to go up a little bit and check ETH0 and you will get the same thing around here. Unfortunately, I don't have it connected. I only have the wireless connected up. You close that, you start the browser, and you type in that IP address. 192.168.8.141. And that will load the local web server on this Raspberry Pi. Here I have added a bunch of information regarding what's installed on it. This web page will of course be available from your computer as well. So for instance, you will see that you have the visualization part on this link here. You have the Influxdb on that link, mysql php myadmin on that link. You have the Node-RED on that link, and it also says how to connect to the VNC or how to connect to the WebMin graphical user interface. It also has some information on how you can become a Patreon member and donate to me or send me some bucks or help me out in some other way. So guys, this is the first part where you actually get it up and running. So let's take a look at how it looks on the computer itself. And if we go down a little bit after we have done it, you'll see that I have some example scripts and how-tos on how to actually connect to the machine and how to start some of the scripts that are there. So basically, now I'm going to show you just quickly how to do the different things. First of all, we go to the web page of this server again, and we know since before it's 8.141 in my case, and here we have it. Visualization, you go to that one, and it will look something like this. Login is the default, so it's admin, and the password is admin as well. Here, when you are greeted with two star dashboards, and that's something that I have created in advance. So for instance, we can go to the PIP 4048, and you will see some of the data here. As you see right now, everything is not available, and that's because we have nothing running fetching data. We can also change the dashboard up here. So we go back and we switch to Batrium. And we have almost the same scenario here. We have some data here, and that's because when I recorded this, I had populated this with that data. So let's go back to the web page again. And we have InfluxDB, I'm not going to go into that, or PHP MyAdmin. Node-RED on the other hand is a nifty little tool. And if you log in here, you'll get a couple of flow pages here. Flow 1, 2, and the total solar power. That's stuff that I have running at home for testing. This is also something that you can leave it be or play around with. We go back again, and we go down a little bit more. you have the login for the VNC and you have the webmin as well. The webmin I'm not going to go into in this case. So now it's time to actually log on to the machine. And I'm going to use PuTTY and go to SSH. You can do this on the terminal, on the screen or the monitor that you have hooked up to the Raspberry Pi as well. 168.8.1.4.1. Default login to Raspberry Pi is as always Pi, and the password is Raspberry. When you log in here, you will get the same error or same message that says that the password should be changed, and you get the normal data here. First, sudo su as described in the manual. We go to the storage folder itself, energy-logger. And in here, we have a couple of stuff. You can list serial devices. You can also list the other type of serial devices. On this machine in question, I do not have anything hooked up, and that's because this is on the bench. If we go to the MPP folder, you will see that we have a couple of different stuff here, and this is just for the PCM60X and the PIP4048. Regarding the PIP4048, I have both for the RS232 and for the USB. Note that the ports on the Raspberry Pi can differ from install to install, so they may not work for you, and if so, you need to go into them, edit them, and change the serial port. I'm not going to go into that today. Let's go back and let's go to the Batrium folder. This is the only one that I can be running without having anything connected to the Raspberry Pi, and that's because I'm utilizing the wireless access to the Batrium. As you see here, we have an .exe file. So we type mono batrium.exe and we start it up. And this will hopefully start to generate dashes. And that means that the file is actually getting data, and the data is being sent to Influxdb. So let's go back to the Grafana now. As you can see now, it did start to populate some of the fields here, and that's because we are getting data. On the top here, you can change the system that you are going to be running. If you do that for your system today, you will most likely get a third number here, 3913 and 7025. That are my two systems that I have running here, so you would most likely be getting a new ID. So you can switch between them like that, and you will be getting data from the other Batrium system. It takes some time to load it up in this case. My Raspberry, I'm running on an old Raspberry Pi, so it takes some time. But as you can see here now, I'm charging with roughly 160 amps to that battery pack. It's 64% filled, and it's going up. If I take the other system, 3913, you can see that that is getting 13 amps. And have 37% state of charge. It's quite empty. So basically, guys, if we go back again, this is how you install the Grafana system that I have created. It's a very, very simple ISO. It doesn't come with any automatic stuff. It's actually merely just an ISO where you can start building stuff. And depending on need, or depending on what you guys want in the future, this may be even more populated with more scripts, more stuff, and more things that will be automated. We'll see about that. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you want to support me in the future, go to my Patreon page or PayPal. Thank you guys for watching, and I see you next time. Oh wait! You maybe wonder, what the heck was I going to do with a hammer? It depends. If you didn't get to work, then you might have need a hammer to actually thrash the Raspberry Pi. Otherwise, I think you should lay it down and be happy that you actually now have the graphing tool running. Once again, guys, thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.